Now that your big eyes are finally opened, now that you're wondering how must they feel, meaning them that you've chased across America's movie screens. Now that you're wondering, how can it be real?
Hi, Appleby. I'm here today to introduce you to a very special Orange Shirt Day chapel service. This week, students and faculty wore orange shirts to promote awareness in Canada about the residential school system and the traumatic impacts it had on the Indigenous communities for a very long time. When I first heard about Orange Shirt Day, the first thing I wondered was why orange out of so many different colors? Well, after researching about it a few years ago, I learned that the orange shirt refers to the shirt that Phyllis Webster received from her grandmother before starting her first day at her residential school. However, when she got to school, they took everything away from her, including the new orange shirt. It was never returned to Phyllis, and the color orange always reminded her of the horrible treatment she received in residential schools. For those of you who are wondering who she is, Phyllis is a brave residential school survivor who started this wonderful initiative. The fact that she overcame her traumatic memories and decided to start this Orange Shirt Day is truly amazing and inspiring. A few years ago, I had a chance to visit the Nelson House community in northern Manitoba with Dr. Palmer, Mr. Peterson, and three Appleby students who all now graduated. Nelson House is a very close and tight-knit Indigenous community who welcomed all of us as if we were a visiting family member. We learned so much about the Indigenous culture, and we had the opportunity to participate in many traditional activities like the Sweat Lodge ceremony and fishing and hunting with them, who truly appreciated the natural species that their land provides. The highlight of my trip, however, was actually visiting a local high school and learning that Indigenous students were just like us. Some had similar interests with me, and we quickly became close, just like how I did with my friends at Appleby. This goes to show that there is no reason for us to keep a distance or to think that the Indigenous communities are even slightly different from us. In fact, I encourage all of you to learn and educate yourself about their beautiful culture and tradition. Orange Shirt Day should not be the only day of the year where we remember the terrible treatment that Indigenous youth received in residential schools. Treat every day like it's the Orange Shirt Day, and I hope you enjoy this chapel service.
We at Appleby College acknowledge that these lands on the shores of Lake Ontario are steeped in Indigenous history. For thousands of years, it has been the traditional land of the Huron-Wendat, the Haudenosaunee, and the Anishinaabeg peoples. Most recently, it has been part of the treaty land and territory of the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation. We acknowledge and thank the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation for being stewards of this traditional territory.
The prayer is a prayer written by an Indigenous Edmontonian who is a survivor of Indigenous residential schools. Creators, help me, ease my pain. Do not let my prayers be in vain. Raise me gently to your clouds on high. Comfort us survivors till the day we die. It's been no easy matter to forgive and forget those who wronged us in their religious net. Still, many of us put it behind and forgave. In our quest for closure, our sanity to save, we have traveled so long, so very far, bearing the memories, healing our scars. We lived with the trauma all of these years. It truly is difficult to stifle these tears. We lose control, let emotions take flight, anytime, any place, be it day or night. No matter how resilient our people may be, only you, Creator, can set us free. So Creator, help us. Ease our pain. Do not allow our prayers to be in vain. Raise us gently to your world on high. Comfort us survivors till the day we die. Amen.
At this time, we invite and encourage you to watch the survivor stories in the description below. This day is a day to learn about and reflect on the realities of Indigenous residential schools in Canada. We challenge you to reflect on what truth and reconciliation means to you, and how you can commit to truth and reconciliation and decolonization in every aspect of your life. We will close the service by honoring the Four Directions in a prayer which was written for a day of prayer for Indigenous justice in 2013.
Come, Great Spirit, as we gather in your name. We face east to your color red, the hue of revelation, to your animal spirit eagle, strong and nurturing, to your lessons calling us to the balance of your spirit in harmony with brothers and sisters. To invoke your wisdom and grace, the goodness of ages, we pray, Come, Holy Spirit, come.
We turn to face the south, to your symbol color gold for the morning star, to your symbol brother sun that enlightens our intellect and brings light to on our path to live responsibly, to your lessons calling us to balance of mind in the spirit of humility, to invoke your spirit of illumination and far-sighted vision, to help us to love you and one another with our whole heart, our whole mind, and our whole soul. We pray, come Holy Spirit, come.
Turn to face west, to your symbol color black, still and quiet, to your animal symbol, the thunderbird, to your symbol, the thunder, mighty and purposeful, to your lessons calling us to balance our emotions in the spirit of gentleness and honesty, to invoke your spirit of introspection, seeing within. Give us your strength and the courage to endure. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
We turn to face north, to our symbol color white of clarity and brightness, to our animal symbol, the swan, which brings us in touch with Mother Earth and growing things, to our lessons calling us to balance of our body in the spirit of a good sense of humor, to invoke our spirit of innocence, trust, and love. Help us to open our eyes to the sadness of every living thing. We pray, come Holy Spirit, come.
We turn to complete the circle and look to our God, our Creator, who cleanses Mother Earth with snow, wind, and rain, to Jesus Christ, the peacemaker who fills us all with the wideness of mercy and lovingly embraces all, and the Holy Spirit who inspires us to action. Come, Holy Spirit, come.